Hey everybody, it's Orochimizu here, and in today's video, I wanted to cover the Chaos Rolin fight in Phantom Pain Cage from a melee perspective and also from a low resource perspective on investing in your characters. With my team setup, I have Liv A and Liv B, and they have basic gear for the most part. None of their memories are upgraded. The weapon is upgraded just a little bit to maybe like level 25, and then their levels are upgraded and they have been promoted. But other than that, everything has been sent to Lucia Dawn. She has an upgraded weapon that's overclocked. She has the memory that is overclocked as well. And she also has the level. So she's my main damage dealer. So the reason why I wanted to cover Rolin first in Phantom Pain Cage versus basically Alpha in the other one is because I got destroyed by Alpha. She moved really fast. I wasn't able to get the timings down and she just kept blinking everywhere and I just couldn't handle it. Maybe my eyes are too old or I'm just too bad. But for the most part, I was able to get used to Rolin's skill set. I've seen it a couple times, especially in the campaign when I was trying to complete it. And I've attempted this run many times, so I finally got used to his attacks for the most part. Alright, so let's get down to the boss fight itself. I'm going to cover this at a slow speed, and then I'll speed it up at a normal speed later. The biggest skill that's going to be annoying is his Scorched Earth passive. So this is pretty much an AoE dot that consistently causes 35 damage to you, and if you don't complete this round quick, you're gonna eventually die, unless you have healers that can prolong your death. So when you first get into the room with Rolin, he's going to do one of two attacks. One which is a series of jump slashes, the next attack is a series of kicks. So you want to dodge both of them. The bullet kick is really annoying because it's harder just to see, and it kind of locks you into animation and does a lot of damage, but for the most part, both of them are pretty easy to dodge because he does it at set timings. So in this case, he's going to attack me with a jump slash as his opener. So what you want to do is just dodge it and attack him from behind. He's wide open. And make sure you keep dodging his attacks and attack him from behind. Because I find that if I dodge to the side and attack him to the side, he's going to hit me because he may have swung wide or have kicked wide. So in his next attack, he's going to do a roundhouse kick. And you're going to want to dodge that one as well, because it does quite a lot of damage. Make sure you don't dodge to the side, dodge behind him. Once you do that, you can do additional follow-up damage to him. As you continue to attack him, he's going to enter his next phase where he jumps away from you, and what he's going to do is do one of two abilities. So if he jumps away from you, he's going to summon a whole bunch of pillars if you stay away from him, and once you see the pillar animation happen, you should dash towards him and attack him. If you don't let him summon the pillars and you just dash towards him right away, then what he's going to do is enter his sight form right away and attack you. So that may ruin your timing and also gives you less time in order to close the gap. Next attack, in this case, is going to be an AoE Rolin attack. You don't want to be behind him attacking him because the AoE Rolin will follow up with the additional attack behind where you take damage. The other attack is an AoE sideswipe, which you could definitely just dodge it and attack him from behind, which is okay. It's very crucial that you kind of stay close to him and also pay attention to his animation, because it's not always guaranteed that he's going to do two whirlwinds in a row or he changes back and forth between the AoE sideswipe and the whirlwind. Sometimes he just keeps doing sideswipes. So you want to make sure that you pay attention to the animation before you attack him. Another thing to keep in mind for Lucia Dawn players is that if you keep just auto attacking, she's going to eventually enter animation where she attacks the enemy and dashes through them on the other side. So I try to not use that animation too much because sometimes it throws me off and I actually dash into the enemy's attack. So be careful about using her auto attacks. He's going to eventually enter the next phase, and the cue for this is when he dashes forward with a whole bunch of swipes, and he's going to look at you and maybe he might do another swiping attack or he might do a whirlwind attack before entering his first phase again, where he does jumping slashes and bullet kicks. This can be tricky if the timing throws you off, because we just came from his sight form where everything felt really fast. His jumping attacks may feel slow to you. Eventually, as you continue to do DPS on him, he's going to enter another phase where he's going to jump far away from you, and he's going to enter his attack called the Flying Man. So the Flying Man, he jumps across the stage and sends a bombardment at you. It's kind of hard to time on the dodge, so I don't have this nailed down yet. I tried to do a support swap, however, I wasn't able to dodge that. His next attack is an explosive barrel that he flings at you and it explodes, and then he follows it up with another Flying Man. So between both of these two attacks, I don't have the timing yet, but if you're able to get the timing down, that's what you need to dodge. Since I'm using my ranged characters and keeping quite a bit of distance between the boss and myself, he's going to switch to his shotgun and attack me. You can dodge this pretty easily, however, if you decide to switch back to your melee character and attack him, he's going to switch back to his jump slash attacks and his roundhouse kicks. In this phase particularly, you want to do as much DPS as you can again. It's pretty easy to dodge these attacks, but if you don't do enough damage, what's going to happen is he's going to move to his second phase again, where he's going to jump away from you and he's going to either summon his pillars or use his whips in order to attack you. And that pretty much covers the boss fight. So it's going to take a while in order to get used to his abilities and his timings, but once you have that down, things are going to get a lot better because you're going to be able to finally fight this boss and try to improve on your scores. I was able to clear the stage, however, I decided to not save my score because I think I can do way better than this. Hopefully this video helps you out on your Phantom Pain Cage runs with Roland on Chaos Mode. I know many of you may have cleared it already, but I know there's a large amount of you that are having trouble with this boss fight, and on top of it, there's a large amount of players that are still trying to progress through their game, and eventually, once they get here, it's going to be a difficult battle, because they're going to be underleveled, or they're going to be undergeared, or a mixture of both. Plus, it's going to be hard, especially in the beginning. Roland is going to probably kick your butt, but eventually, as you keep trying and trying and trying, you're going to learn the timings, you're going to learn his animations, you're going to learn how to control your character better, and then you're going to find out what works for you. And if you keep trying, eventually you're going to get better at it, and then you're going to be able to clear it. So this is why I like punishing Grey Raven so much. It's challenging, yet it's also really satisfying once you clear it. Alright, the only thing left to show you is basically the whole fight at 100% speed. It's much faster than what I'm showing you. So this is reduced down by 50%, I believe. And at 100%, this battle is very fast paced, especially when you have to press numerous buttons. Also to note is that as you continue to play, it's going to get easier as you play through the modes, because technically as you play, you're going to level up, get more weapons, get more memory, upgrade them, and you're just going to get stronger overall. So as the game progresses, you're going to find that the other modes are going to get easier. But in this case, playing through Chaos and Hell Mode might be a challenge so far in our current state since the game just released. What's coming up next is a clip at normal speed, and also I included a clip where I played this mode the next day because I leveled up and got stronger. I hit level 45, so I got a pretty nice power spike, and I was able to clear this stage a lot easier, especially since I had more practice. I was able to get the timing down. However, I did choke at the end, so I didn't get a totally clean run, so I'm still trying my hardest on this. But that's it for me, and if you like what you saw, click that like and subscribe button down below, and I'll catch you guys later in the next video.
現在 HP がやや危険領域です。キャッチ。 戦闘終了。お次の戦闘は何ですか？
お次の戦闘は何ですか？